How's it? Spike from Wavescape here with the forecast for the JBU Supertrial presented by Ruka. Just looking at today, Friday the 27th of May, on the Wavescape chart, and you can see that 11 foot 14 second swell from the southwest is running in the open ocean in the Eastern Cape. And JBay was a lovely, clean and glassy 4 to 5 feet with the odd 6 foot set this afternoon. So moving forward to the first day of the window period next week, Wednesday the 1st and the 2nd of June, you'll see also a similar kind of swell, maybe a little bit smaller, but very similar direction and a similar energy. And the storm behind that, I will show you now. And basically it's this storm here that's forming on this Saturday on the 28th of May. And as you can see there, it kind of splinters into two chunks, but there's a lot of energy and a big section of the ocean has got a gale force wind with a nugget of hurricane force wind there in the middle of that. It's a little bit too west to my liking. One would hope that it would be somewhere around here and pointing straight at JBay. That would be a dead cert. But if you look at the peak period of that particular swell, let's just move through this weekend, and then there's another little pulse on Sunday, which is not obviously part of that storm. Now you see that, here we go, this pulse is starting from that storm we've just looked at, and there it travels through the ocean a couple of days, and then it arrives in Cape Town and starts to arrive along the Southern Cape towards the Eastern Cape on Wednesday the 1st at 8 a.m., and then fills in during the day. And then it peaks around about this time. There's another little nugget pulse there, which is probably from that that initial, you know, that core, hardcore, powerful wind that was in the Fetch. And by Thursday as well, there's quite a lot of swell, but it's fading quite fast. And the trouble, of course, is that it looks like the swell peaks in the evening and in the morning, straddling the 2 days, which is never ideal when you surf forecasting. And then for the rest of the period, there doesn't seem to be a huge amount of action. That storm, as you see, fades off. There's quite a lot of west wind, southwest wind in the ocean, but that's pointing in the wrong direction for JBay, of course. And then as we move to Tuesday to Wednesday, good winds blowing on the day that in question. So let's hold thumbs that that swell transpires, as we hope. Now, this high pressure system is causing a lot of trouble, and that's going to basically sit in place for the rest of the window period, barring a few small breakages in the air pressure. But basically, this is forcing all the storms to pass south of the country. There it goes. And another storm that's coming there on the other side of this band of high pressure systems, it gets deflected south and it just moves down and away. So the storm winds in that storm are facing in a bad direction. And one can only hope that this high pressure here that forms down here on Saturday next weekend, here it is again, this storm here, high pressure, if that can actually cause a very good southerly pressure gradient between one of this, especially when you get to this point here and here, you see there's a storm there, and sometimes it can blow a very hard southerly wind, but that seems to be a little bit of a pie in the sky, wishful thinking kind of vibe. And then this high pressure system sinks to the south and is really strong. So all the storms are just moving along to the east below that band of high pressure systems. And again, and again, and again, and again, and again into the last day of the waiting period. And just to show you that the jet stream track, which is upper atmosphere winds in the jet stream, thousands and thousands of feet up, they basically often dictate the movement of the storms, the storm tracks that are at the surface. And as you can see, these are moving in a very west to east trajectory. What you want, of course, is for this trajectory to be coming from up this way towards the country and then dipping down, rather than coming from the top and going down past the country, because that means swell directions and wind speeds and directions that are facing basically a bad direction. And then we go right through to the end of the period. So let's hold thumbs for Wednesday and Thursday next week. Thanks.